Good day once again, everybody. Our second subject, which is the last subject for today, is civic education, and the topic we are going to look into is anger and self-control. Anger and self-control. What is anger? Anger is having strong feeling of wanting to hurt or abuse someone because they have wronged you. That is when you have this strong urge, like just want to hurt someone because that person has offended you, that person has done something bad to you. So that is anger. While self-control is the ability to behave sensibly and calmly even when you feel angry, offended, or excited. So self-control, no, it is when you behave sensibly, when you feel angry, offended. No, somebody just offended you. And you know, you just exercise patience, you exercise self-control, you don't want to get involved in any fight. So that is self-control. And it is not only when you are angry or when you feel offended, that is when you can exercise self-control. Even when you are excited, when you are overexcited, when you are very happy, you need to exercise self-control. You don't need to do irrelevant things just all in the name of I'm very, very happy today, my dad just did this for me. You don't have to do something that is stupid, let me put it in that way. So you have to exercise self-control too. And let's continue. It can also be defined as the ability to control one's motion, behaviors, and desires in the face of external demands. Yes, even when you are outside your home, anywhere you go to, you need to exercise self-control. You might go to a place where things that are there are very enticing, are very tempting to the eye, that you feel like picking from them, but you just have to exercise self-control. It is not for you. If you pick them, they will call you a thief. But exercising self-control, you can just admire those things from afar. Do you understand? It will show you are well trained from home. Now let's move to the results of anger. Number one, disrespect. Yes, any person that gets angry too often gets very angry. People won't like that person, and that person won't be respected. Actually, it is not that it's not good to get angry. Even the Bible said it. You can get angry, but it must not be too much. Too much of it is very, very bad. Anger can solve most of the things. Anger can solve them. Most things are solved with calmness. Do you understand? So, if somebody is trying to cheat you or is trying to do something bad to you, yes, you can get angry so that the person will just take it for granted. But that does not mean you should take it to the extent of fighting or destroying things. You understand? So, number one result of anger is disrespect. Any person that gets angry, you know, very, very angry, that person won't be respected. Number two, headache. Medically, it will cause headache for you. Number three, depression. Number four, stroke. Number five, heart attack. Number six, violence. That is when anger has gotten to another stage, a higher level stage. From violence, no. Number seven, to murder. That is when, you know, it has gotten to an higher level stage and it is very, very, very bad. Number eight, high blood pressure. Let's move to ways of managing anger. Number one, if you feel out of control, walk away from the situation temporarily until you cool down. If you feel out of control, like somebody just offended you, like, and you are very, very angry, just walk away from that scene, walk away from that place. Because if you are still there, the person might still continue to do something that will get on your wrong side, that will annoy you. So it is better you walk away from that situation temporarily for a moment until you cool down. And number two, recognize and understand the emotions as normal and part of life. Yes, anger is a normal, like I said this earlier, it is not that it is bad to get angry, but it must not be too much. It is also part of life, so that some people won't just take you for granted, but it must not be too much to the extent of violence or murder or destroying things or fighting. Now let's look at the results of self-control. Number one, it ends up bringing you happiness when you're able to control yourself, to control yourself in the face of anger or any other tempting things, it ends up bringing you happiness. That okay, I didn't do any mistake here, or I didn't perform any error here. Number two, it makes one honorable and respected. Any person that have self-control will be respected. People will respect that person for that particular character. Number three, it helps a person to become more attractive. Yes, people will want to relate with that kind of person. You won't want to relate with the person that gets very, 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 very angry, that gets angry almost every time. You would even get tired because you won't know what you do next, and the person will be angry or mad at you. But someone that has self-control, that is self-disciplined, will attract people to them. Number four, it helps a person from falling into error. Yes, those people that get angry to the extent of destroying things, to the extent of physical assault, to the violence, all those like that. After they've done all those things, if you notice them very well, they will now be feeling remorse. They will be regretting what they've done. Why they were angry, they didn't know. Do you understand? That is why it is good to practice self-control. It will save you from falling into any error. And number five, it helps a person to be well disciplined. Yes, it will help you to be well, very well disciplined. So I hope you go through this audio explanation. You write the notes as usual, and you can go through this audio explanation over and over again to understand the notes. If there's any question you want to ask me, feel free to ask. I will reply you. Thanks.